Today I'm here to talk to you about my favorite wedding lens for the Canon mirrorless lineup, the 85 f2. Welcome to the studio. You might have seen in some of the videos, even the videos last year. For a period before the Z6 II came out, the R6 was actually my main camera. I was shooting two of them on a wedding day. I had the 85mm f1.2, so the L version of it that's, if I had to ballpark it, I'm gonna say it's like, no, I'm kidding. It's big, it's heavy. I don't know if I did a review of that officially, but it actually gave me a repetitive strain injury in my wrist because of the way that it balances and my body just wasn't used to it. 7200, totally fine. That 85 1.2, I wish that I would've got the 50. I feel like the 51-2 would have been a better fit. That was all before this came out though, this 85 f2. For me as a wedding photographer, I would say this is the perfect lens. One, it fits the budget. The 85 1.2 is wildly expensive. Two, as a wedding photographer first, and then also video creator some of the time, this is an additional benefit to actually have. So this has stabilization in the lens. So you have lens stabilization as well as stabilization in the body, which means hand-holding 85 millimeter footage at F2 with the beautiful autofocus of this Canon, it's the Canon R6 you're seeing right now. It makes it very, very easy to create video content, which is great because I'm doing both photography and also video coverage. And that means that my rate of working on the day is very, very quick. So if I'm able to actually just do video very easily and not have to worry too much about it, and I know that I can get the clip. One thing I will mention, and I'll be talking more about this in the channel, is that if you are somebody that does hybrid coverage on the R6 is still a little challenging. Basically, the situation is if you're in manual photo mode, you wish you could just click the record button and you'd be recording in manual settings, but it launches into automatic movie mode. So you may, if you're a heavy hybrid shooter, the R5 might be a better option for you. Or even, the Canon R also makes it easy, but the sad part with that is that there's only one card slot. So that's a bit of an unfortunate thing. So I think the R5 is kind of the wedding camera that I would go for if I am a hybrid shooter on the Canon system. This would be my main lens, the 85 f2, and then my second camera body would probably be exactly what this is set up as, which is the R6 with the 35 millimeter. I'm interested to see when more primes come out. The 24 was, I don't know if it was announced or leaked or something like that, but the same kind of version as this, so maybe an f1.8 or maybe an f2 version of it. I would be super curious to see that. That would probably become, I would say, my main second camera body wedding lens, that if I'm 85 on main and 24 on the other, that's great. 35 works also. I've been super happy with it. And together, those two lenses, you can cover an entire wedding. This lens specifically is also a macro lens. So the 85 can double as a macro lens or just is a macro lens. The button that's up here, so basically it allows you to limit the focus possibilities of the lens. So I always have it in the middle button where it can go from 0.5 of a meter, so something like that, to infinity. Basically, I discovered that if the lens decided like, hey, something's really close, I'm gonna go into like macro mode. When it goes into macro mode, it takes a while for it to get all the way back out to telephoto human out there mode. So limiting it at about 0.5 of a meter, I'm totally happy with. Or when I actually am doing macro coverage of maybe a ring or whatever might be invitations, there's actually a macro limiter as well. So you can put it on that. If you notice your lens is going a little bit weird, maybe know that that's probably the reason. This hasn't happened to me actually, which is nice, but when I used to have some of my Nikon cameras on at least the 7200, if I had it on a strap and just like hanging off my side, it would tend to bump the focus limiter button, or it would move it from autofocus / manual to manual focus. And I'd pull it up to shoot the ceremony. Somebody's walking out, I'm like, what's going on? My autofocus isn't working. And so check the buttons first before like freaking out. If you notice that it's a problem, I don't think it's a problem with this. Like it's very difficult, not completely difficult, but it's you have to move these buttons with intention. If you do see that being a problem for you, you can also gaff tape it so that they just don't ever move on you as well. So it really is a balanced decision. The 85 1.2 creates amazing images. Shooting at 1.2 just creates a look and a feeling that I absolutely love. But in the balanced spectrum of things, to have the 85 f2 that's a little bit smaller, way easier to carry, way less expensive, comes with stabilization in the lens and is also a macro lens, for me, this is the choice. That there really is no competition whatsoever. I would say that a tipping point for me would be if maybe the 85 1.2 was $500, $600, $700 less and also had stabilization in it. I feel like at that point, I might stay on that side of things, but with the added features of this, really it's the lens that I'm gonna have on my camera anytime that I'm shooting a wedding on the Canon mirrorless system. And those are my thoughts on the Canon 85 millimeter F2. it's a great lens. Just that's it. I feel like every sentence in this review has been, it's a great lens. It does good things. It fits a lot of needs. If you're into photography only and video is not a concern for you at all, and maybe budget is also not a concern at all, the 85 1.2 is obviously an amazing lens, and I loved it a lot when I had it. But for me, this just ticks all of the boxes, whereas that one ticked the really shallow depth of field box only. Maybe to speak quickly about the depth of field differences that I notice is that in real life, basically the difference between f1.2 and f2, if you're able to get a couple of steps closer, you can get kind of pretty close to that look. You won't get quite the creamy, dreamy out of focus area as the 1.2, but you can get pretty close. And again, as kind of a balance, I feel like it's more than good enough for any of my clients. Side-by-side images, yeah, like you're gonna see a little bit of a difference, 1.2 versus f2. But clients at the end of the day are going to love the images that come off of this lens with Canon R6 or an R5 if you're at a wedding, or Canon R if you're maybe not at a once in a lifetime moment. And that brings us to the end of the video. If you have any comments, please drop them in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you like photography things. Specifically wedding photography things is pretty much all we do here now. Subscribe to the channel and share this with 150 of your closest friends. No, I'm kidding, you don't have to do that. But thanks for being here and made it to the end of the video. So thanks, appreciate it. Have a good day.